Okay, so now that we have a basic scene set up inside of Blender from imported models off of Sketchfab or from any other 3D modeling software or marketplace, wherever you want to source your models is fine. All that matters now is that we have a scene set up. This is just a visual scene of what you want your world to look like. This is when we have to start digging in to what the Nowhere plugin is all about and why we need it in order to make a Nowhere space, a Nowhere world that you can export and use inside of our platform. Basically, the Nowhere exporter, the Nowhere plugin, is going to export to a GLTF, similar to how Blender can using the file export to GLTF. But the key difference is we're going to be encoding very specific GLTF extras that Nowhere will use to identify certain aspects of your world as collision meshes, as entities that will be replaced with different meshes or user interfaces in engine / in world. So yeah, long story short, you must click export through our plugin. I'm going to give a quick walkthrough of each part of the plugin and what it does now. So if you open up the scene properties tab in Blender, which looks like a little teardrop and a circle next to it and a little smaller circle next to that medium-sized black circle. That's the right here where the mouse is. This is the scene properties tab. That's where all of the functions of the Nowhere plugin live. The first tab we're going to take a look at is the Nowhere project tab. In this tab, this is where we're going to name our project and where we're going to specify an export folder for this blend. And when we do this, let's just save the blend for good practice anyways. So let's title this Artistic Food. Okay, so the name of the world is going to be Artistic Food, and we're going to pick a folder to export in. Generally, you can either export in the folder that you're working out of, or you can pick a completely different folder. In this case, I'll do it out of the folder we're going to be working out of. So I'm going to go to our world building, my world building folder, and I'm going to make a new folder. I haven't saved the blend yet either, so this is where we're going to end up saving our blend. We're going to call this Artistic Fruit. And we'll go ahead and accept this as our location to export our world. I'm sorry, let's actually make a folder in here called export. And this is where our exports are going to go for this demo world, Artistic Fruit World. So we'll double click that and accept. At the same time, let's go ahead and save this blend and go back to world building, Artistic Fruit, and we'll call it Artistic Fruit. So now we have a saved blend and we have an export folder. So this is used right here to specify, like I said before, where the export is going to go and what the name of your world is going to be. This button right here is used to export your world when you are done with it. And you have to click this export GLTF button. You cannot go through the menu and export a GLTF. You also have pretty handy commands down here that are used to select collision meshes, entities, or world meshes. So right now we should have all world meshes. If we go ahead and click the world button, it selects all of our meshes in the world that are considered world meshes, which is a great handy function. If you click entities, it won't select anything because we don't have any entities in there right now. And I take that back. We added a spawn location just for size reference, and it selected the spawn location. This is a player entity. So that's what the entities, select entities button does. And then you can also select all your collision meshes, which we haven't made any collision meshes yet. But when we do, you'll be able to select them using this button. You also have a Nowhere scene panel, and this panel is going to allow you to adjust like your scene level properties, including your gravity, your respawn height, and that's like a plane that at a certain height, when the player falls past it, it will respawn them, right? So if you put it like at -1 meters, as soon as they jump off this table or go beneath the XY plane, they'll get respawned at the top. But if you make it 100 meters or -100 meters, they'll have a much longer fall and they'll be able to jump back up. You can also enable and disable fog, change the color of fog, start and end distance of fog, etc. And then you have the nowhere entities panel. And this is just generally where you're going to click to place different entities in the blend that are specific to nowhere. So your player entity, teleporters, screens, content, your portals, triggers, and link blocks are all going to be placed into the blend file using these buttons. You also have specific nowhere tabs that pop up when you click on a mesh. So if I go ahead and click on this table mesh, you're going to see an NWR geometry tab pop up. This geometry panel will be discussed in further detail in a future video, but this is where you can change whether it's a collision or world type, change your billboarding. You can also add animation chain steps. And then if you were to select a light, which we have one light in our scene, which we're going to end up deleting actually for this world because we made everything a background shader, but you'll be able to select if it's default, static, or dynamic. And I'll go into further detail in a separate video about how lights work inside of nowhere.